powered by a battery, electric scooters or e-scooters can be seen zipping around the streets of Washington, D.C. For tourists coming to the U.S. Capitol, these colorful scooters have become the latest attraction.
Yeah, it's super fun.
Because they're great fun.
Because it's really fun and it's a lot quicker than walking.
They have quickly become an option for people who aren't going far enough to justify a taxi but don't want to wait for a bus or walk.
We're just really trying to provide options to the district residents, to our visitors, low-cost options. And scooters is just another low-cost option that allows people to be able to traverse throughout the city. And it seems to be a very economical route, as well as good for the environment as well.
But not everyone is on board. The growing number of scooters taking over sidewalks bothers many. D.C. City Council member Mary Chay has introduced a bill to ban scooters from 10 p.m. to 4 a.m. to reduce accidents in the dark. But officials from one scooter company disagree with the late-night ban and insist the scooters are perfectly safe if riders follow the rules.
In our app, when you open up our app, it says very simply, not to ride on the sidewalk, ride in a bike lane when a bike lane arises. And also we do a thing called geofencing, which is in the app there's a map and it says where you can and cannot go, basically.
Though we don't see many riders actually using helmets.
The problem is nobody wears a helmet.
Doesn't really fit in my backpack.
There are 8 different companies offering e-scooter services in Washington, D.C. with thousands of daily users. Everett Lott says these scooters do not pose a safety risk.
We've had about 150 incidents reported during about an 8-month time span. And again, less than 25% of those were happening during the evening times. But in terms of specific types of injuries, I haven't seen any data to reflect that.
Some scooter companies offer training for first-time riders. But as with the helmet, there haven't been many takers. Sadia Zebranja, VOA News, Washington.